Whoever says therapy is good for the body, you're a fucking liar. Turbulence 2, Fear of Flying. In this sequel, of course, to the 1997 movie, you have a group of people trying to get over one of their therapy sessions, basically a fear of flying class, and once they graduate, they celebrate by giving the group a trip to LA. Unfortunately for that group, another group of terrorists skyjack the plane and kills the pilot, threatens to kill all the passengers with chemical weapons, and of course for money purposes, and it's up to one of the passengers to land the airplane. This movie, I'm just gonna come out right out and say it, this movie is stock footage heavy. It has almost every scene from the original Turbulence present, only with maybe 2 to 3 new added airplane scenes. All the rest of the airplane scenes are compiled from the original Turbulence movie. But it's still a good and decent movie. It's a little bit darker than the original. The original, for me, I kind of consider the original Turbulence like a dark comedy of some sorts. This one is more of a serious tone, which I appreciate a little bit more because I do like my serious airplane hijacking movies, you know what I mean? And whoever this guy is, I don't know who he is. He's like the main guy in the whole movie. You see it through the whole movie. He also comes in Turbulence 3. I'm not sure if he plays the same character in that movie, but he has a little bit of a different look to him in that movie, which I'll get to. But, yeah, then you also got Jennifer Beals in here. She's fucking gorgeous. And she's probably the main good actor in this movie. The acting is subpar okay. Like, the main bad guy, he's pretty cool. I like him. He was funny. Some scenes. And, yeah, I can agree with them. One of them passengers, the lady, yeah, she was a pain in the ass. So the bitch slap is justified for me. Because I would have done it. Like, shut the fuck up, bitch. But yeah, the acting is okay. The movie's only like 96 minutes at best. So I think it's about maybe a few minutes longer than the original one, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, it's not a bad entry into the series. I thought it was well done. Especially for a direct-to-video movie, or home direct-TV movie, basically. Since it's a low budget movie, some of the effects are really kind of cheap. But again, I'm not gonna damn it too badly because it was direct to video basically, so you can't really fault it for that. As long it doesn't look like what the Asylum makes today. See, back in the 90s, when the movie was direct to video, they still put fucking effort in it. The Asylum doesn't do that. Okay, so I appreciate they use stock footage instead of newly created, poorly CGI, updated shots of an airplane, where they actually just went with the original stuff. That works a lot better. And you end up with a very entertaining movie at that. And for that reason alone, I'm going to give Turbulence 2 a B+. Still enjoyed it. Probably my favorite one. My second favorite of the trilogy so far. So let me know what you guys think about Turbulence 2 down below. Did you like it? Did you hate it? Which one you like the most out of all three? And let me know down below, and I'll catch y'all on the third one.